We're going to give him hell tonight, Frank. Oh, cheer up, you miserable git.
Look, I'm all right, Dave. Just take it easy.
I say, somebody's nicked my funny fashion silk mitts. They're sticking out of your pocket, oh boy. Yeah, I'll grab that, Frank. Come on, Sally. Come on, John. Put a sock in.
I hope our lot are keeping their lot awake.
Doris is asleep.
Yeah, I bet she sleeps through an air raid. Oh, it's like living in a chicken run, isn't it? There were like three old hens in a chicken run. Did you enjoy the dance?
I've never been much before without a chap. You feel as if you're up for sale where they look you up and down.
We've got a part-time warden next door, but one and every time there's a raid, they say he goes around comforting frightened women with a Bible in one hand and his stirrup pump in the other. Open by the raid.
It's never been as bad as this before. We've had 5 raids in a row now. Sometimes I wonder if there'll be anything left.
Well, they can fetch this lot down with pleasure, so long as I'm not in it. David hates coming back here. He always has done. Since he got that last promotion. Oh, God. I'm dreading getting a commission.
When did you all leave?
I don't know. If it comes, it comes. Went to see the kids last week. I'd never have known. Mrs. Thomas hadn't wrote and told me. Ever since we got married, and it looked as if it had beaten the record then. It practically touches the floor when there's 2 of you in it.
Shh. Doris.
I can live off the nothing money now, you see. And so I save what David sends me. I've got quite a lot put by.
Oh. I hope Mum and Margaret are all right. I hate being away when it's like this.
When's the baby due?
You know?
Yeah. She came round the other night and told me all about it. We've always got on very well, Margaret and me, ever since John went missing. Pity she can't marry this chap, really. He sounds quite nice.
Yeah. We, don't talk about it much at home. Because of Mum. Just try and pretend it never happened.
Locked her for 6, didn't it? Margaret, of all people. It's only people like me who are supposed to do that sort of thing. Is there any tea left in the flask?
Sorry, Mum, it's all gone. I'll make some more. Keeps us trying to sleep.
I could go, Mrs. Ashton.
No, thank you. I can manage.
I shouldn't go out just yet, Mum.
Well, it's quiet in there. Hope Frieda doesn't try and come home.
No, she'll stay at Sheila's. Look, let Michael go and make some tea.
No, thank you. I can manage. I expect you'll be wanting to get home to your little girl, won't you, Mr. Armstrong?
I sent her away to my sister's last week away from the bombing.
Oh, I see. We know what that means. An empty house, you and me. Her imagination will be working overtime. Talk about shutting the stable door after the horse has bolted.
I think I will go.
I'm sorry. It's not very nice for you, is it? Or was she just shout or something?
I start working nights next week.
Oh? Well, that'll put her mind at rest.
Perhaps she's right. Perhaps it would be better if we left things as they are for the time being. It's convenient, isn't it?
Convenient?
There's someone to look after you. It's comfortable. It's home.
Very good. Listen, Jack, I put it in your boots. A sugar in one, a dozen eggs in the other, so watch where you put in your feet. Hey? No, I'll not be on when you get here. Right you are, then. Hello, Edwin.
Hello, Ted.
The pot's still warm.
Good. I was hoping it would be.
Have the rescue lads turned up at Margaret Street yet?
Yes, that's why I came back. I was getting in the roads. They couldn't see the wood for the trees.
What's the roll call?
We've got the father. He'd be all right, I think. The mother's dead, with the lintel over and the kiddies underneath. Still breathing, they say, but the doctor looked a bit grim.
Put that in your pocket. Mum's the word. Half a pound of home cured.
Oh, thanks very much, dear. That's very kind of you.
That'll be tempting to you.
What? Oh, yes, of course.
I just heard a very funny story there about an old lady going for a meat ration, you know.
Aye.
The butcher wrapped it up in a tram ticket and she lost it on her way home. It fell through the punch hole.
There we are, tempers.
Don't you like my stories, Edwin?
What?
I just told you a funny story.
Well, tell me it again, Ted.
I never tell a good story twice. Heard from Robert?
Not since we had that telegram thing about the beginning of March. 3 standard phrases in his name from somewhere he's not allowed to mention. It's not much for a worried mother, is it?
Here, I heard a very good one this morning about a sergeant major. Now, this sergeant major, he was talking to the lads on parade.
How was Cologne, then?
Bang on. We nearly ditched the old kite, though, coming in. Good show, though, all things considered.
Good show? You're off on leave tomorrow, aren't you?
What do you mean tomorrow? It's today. The day, old chap. Sun will be shining out there in a couple of hours.
Oh, I missed the post that letter, by the way. Old Batty caught me and kept me talking.
That's all right, kid. I'll be able to catch the old lady at it. Nice surprise for her, won't it?
Oh, Teddy Main's been after you. Says you owe him a fiver.
Well, he's not sweating for it, is he?
Yeah, I think he is.
Well, you can square him, can't you?
What do you mean?
Oh, come on, Frank. We all know you're loaded.
Look, if he wants the fiver, Dave, he wants the fiver.
Charge him commission on it.
Oh, well, don't bring me into it.
Oh, you're a great chum. You are great. Look, you know, he can't be that hard up. His old man is loaded.
Huh. Like, who's talking? Your old man owns a bloody printing works, doesn't he?
Yeah, all right, but I'm going on leave tomorrow, so he'll just have to wait till I get back, won't he?
I did your register yesterday.
Yeah, did you?
Well, I had to, same as everybody else, and it's a performance. Of course, it won't bother you with being in the naffin. They'll not worry you, Frieda, because you're only after them who aren't working. Oh, now, where is it? It's outside.
Oh, yeah, it's in the yard, love. Hey, kick the door open before you go in. Only there was a rash in there.
Oh!
Oh, yeah, they're all over the place since the bombing. My dad says he saw dozens of them crossing the street the other night, hand in hand. Pink ones, he said.
Oh, Sheila.
The old boozer.
Oh, well, better get dressed, I suppose.
I'm not on until 7 tonight. 7 until 12, short shift. I shall have to do with this. Oh, hello, where's the post?
Is it from David?
No.
Mum got a letter from him on Monday.
Oh, did she? No, I don't get letters from David anymore, only about him.
About him? Who from?
I don't know. I don't even bother to read them anymore. They're always the same.
What are they about? What do they say?
But he got a girl pregnant with that last county with that.
David? Have you told him?
Oh, I told him about the first one, but he said it wasn't true.
He said it was probably somebody who was jealous of him.
You don't believe them, do you?
Yes, I do.
Sheila, that's ridiculous.
Oh, you don't think I want to believe it, do you? Don't you think I haven't tried not to? And every time I begin to forget, I get another letter to remind me.
I'm sorry, Anne.
Now, look, Frieda, don't you tell your mother, will you? I tried talking to her about it once. She must have been mad. She'd never believe that, never in a million years. Poor old Margaret.
Why do you say that?
Because I don't think she'll ever forgive her, that's all. Mine never forgave me.
Ooh, what time do your clear go?
Oh, I don't know. You rest.
Oh, I even thought it was the sirens again if I'd seen a rat.
I was talking to Frieda last night. She said that you'd been bombed out.
Yeah, it was that last bad raid. We was all in a shelter house, we'd have had it. I'm an unwelcome lodger now at my sister's.
You wouldn't like to come and stay here, I suppose.
Were you?
Well, you could have the kids' room. The bed's not much better. Our Maureen has slept on it.
Oh, Sheila, are you sure? I mean, I'd pay you some.
No, no, share the rations, that's all right. I'd be glad of the company, honestly. You could come tonight if you're interested.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I would like to.
You won't mind being on your own, though, will you? Only I work funny hours, you see.
Oh, no, not a bit. I'm used to being on my own.
Good. We'll see how it works out then, shall we?
Hey, have you heard from Peg since, you know?
You just had to bring that up, didn't you?
I just wondered, Axel.
Well, you just watch it while I'm away.
Hey?
I said watch it with a skirt.
What skirt?
Any skirt. Don't go making any rash promises just because Daddy's not around to look after you.
Are you in a good mood or something?
I'm going on leave, aren't I, Frankie? Boy, to me own.
Hey, get off!
You want to get married, you know, Frank? You don't know what you're missing.
Me? You're joking.
Hey, I'll tell you something, though. I've been in this lot for 3 bleeding years now, and there's 2 things I've never got used to.
What's that?
Sleeping next to you, and that bloody thing there. Ta-da.
Ta-da.
Oh, you off, Dave? Yeah. That's a 5 quid you owe me. I'm a bit short right now.
Oh, tell you, I haven't got it. You can manage till I get it back, can't you?
Well, I won't be here, old boy. I got my dues. Commission. Let's have a drink to it.
Since when?
This morning. Just been to see Batty. Well, didn't he send for you?
Nope.
For bad luck. Well, you're a bit overdue for it, really, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
Now, about the money, the fiver.
Look, Teddy, I haven't got it.
Oh, well, Frankie here's not going anywhere, are you, Frankie?
Not that I know of, no.
Now, you're a thrifty sort of bloke. You lend Dave the 5 quid and he'll sting his old man when he gets back to Liverpool. You'll be all right. He's always telling us how stinking rich the old boy is. All right, Dave?
No. Frank hasn't got 5 quid.
Yeah, I have. Well, now, there's a charm for you. Well, aren't you going to send me on my way? Here's to Pilot Officer Teddy May.
Congratulations, good luck, mate. Teddy.
Well, Dave, if I don't see you again, love to the wife. Thanks for the money, Frankie. All the best.
Cheeky bastard. I'm sorry about the fiver, Frank.
I'll bring it back with me, all right?
Yeah. Hey, don't worry about the commission. It's that bloody accent of his.
Yeah.
Keep trying, you'll get there in the end.
Shut up.
I knew she was in trouble, of course, but I thought, wait to be told, Sefton, wait to be told. I wouldn't have thought it of your Margaret. I wouldn't. The last person on earth.
Yes, well, there it is.
You'll marry her, of course, is chap?
In 7 years.
Yes. I'd forgotten about that. It's a funny state of affairs, it is. Things aren't what they used to be, Jean. It seems a good long time since I saw anybody making their own bread. I tried to get Mrs. Foster to do it, but she won't. That stuff from the shop gives me indigestion.
You never said how Tony was.
Oh, he's got himself a girlfriend. I don't quite know what the situation is there either. But what can you do? There's our Joe as well, out there in the Middle East with all those Australians. Tempting providence, if you ask me.
People along the road are talking, of course.
That's the worst part of it.
It's not for myself, I mind. It's her. When she goes out in the morning, I can almost see her bracing herself to cope with it. That'll be Edwin. Don't tell him I talked to you about it.
Well, it's all family, isn't it?
Robert!
What?
Hello, Robert!
I didn't tell you were coming, love.
Oh, I didn't have time. I just put me washing.
Here.
tear it or anything now, are you?
If you say things like that, love, you'll hurt me feelings. A little more big than you've had at dinners. Haven't I, Ralph? Is he still there?
Could you put it up for me?
Oh, well, now you see, I start my taxi round in an hour,
love. Go on, be a sport.
You're tempting me, aren't you?
Only I haven't got a man, you see.
And a man, I see.
He's in the Air Force, cheeky.
If he's in the Air Force, he's bound to be cheeky. Come on, Ralph, I'll take that in on the ascent. We mustn't put too much strain on your trust, must we? Don't worry,
I'll
put it together.
Okay. I'll put the kettle on, shall I?
Was it gas come on again?
Yeah, come on last night.
Right,
I'll hold
the door
in
the fire.
And it's
men!
Oh, hello.
Hello. Rob,
have you?
Yeah, what's left of it, but yours is still buried under the rubble. Should have sent Chester to Oceans. Well, both, really.
Oh, I'm glad you've come. I've been as miserable as sin here on my own.
Well, they're all smiles and laughs. Everybody's happy, aren't they?
Anyway, make yourself at home, won't you? I'm on at the naffy in half an hour, but I'll be back about 12, unless the siren goes, and I might stop on there in the cellars. But you'll be all right on your own.
Oh, yeah. Hey, do I lock the door?
No, well, I don't, just in case, you know, anything happens, in case the siren goes.
Yeah.
Now, there's bits of stuff to eat in the kitchen, and if you want to take your things up, it's the door on the left.
Right, well, I'll take them now.
Someone you got fixed up around here?
Yeah. Don't take any notice of him. He thinks he's Max Miller. They've brought me bed. First bit of new furniture. Oh, I can't wait for David to see it.
We moved right around the coast to a place called Lagos.
Oh, Lagos, yes, I remember.
Well, there's a swimming pool there, sort of a great big sheet of canvas all stretched out over this hole in the ground, you see. Any time any of the lads jumped in. A lizard jumped.
Oh, it's a lovely table, Robert. You seen it, Sefton?
Yes, I was wondering what it was. Ah, nice bit of inlay there.
Must have cost you a fortune, though.
Just a pair of socks.
A pair of what?
Just an old pair of very high-quality socks that you knitted for me, Fred.
Oh, thanks very much. And all this time I've been thinking of keeping your toes.
Well, they were too long in the foot, you see.
That's all right, you needn't explain.
Got them off a chap in a bumboat.
Yes, a good few hours have gone into that. But labour's cheap out there, isn't it? How did you manage to get it here?
In pieces, Uncle.
Catch sight of any submarines, lad?
Not a sausage, Uncle. Lots of the lads have been out there for years and never seen one.
Stand by a bit. Hope he's remained seated. Carry on talking. Now, what have we got here? One slightly sampled bottle of special.
Oh, that's good Lord, where'd you get that, son?
You're in the wrong mobile, chap. Well, I wish I could stop and have one with you, but Sheila doesn't know I'm here yet.
Ah, stay and have one little drink, love, surely. She'll understand.
Of course she will. It's ages since we had two of you lads home together.
Yeah, all right, I'll have a quick glass.
Come on, get the glasses, Frida.
I had a letter from Phil the other week, Dad.
Oh?
Yes. So, when's he getting his commission?
I'm not sure he wants one, son.
He what? I'll grab mine with both hands. I can do with the extra boblets.
Isn't Margaret coming back?
Yes, she'll be back soon.
Here we are, then. Here, lad. My treat. Take it out of that.
Oh, thanks. I was hoping it was somebody's treat. I'm skint.
Well, don't they pay you in the Air Force?
Oh, yes. 15 bob a day. Do you fancy joining us, Uncle Sefton?
Well, that's not so bad, is it? It's not so bad.
Well, Robert to David. And our thoughts to Philip. And Tony, too, of course.
Sheila was round last night. She came to have a bath.
We got her bars and shelter, you know, one of those table jobs. She'll be sound asleep in it by the time you get home.
They might at least let us get the washing up done.
I'll see to the washing up. You and madam here get the shelter ready.
Well, I suppose I'd better make a dash for it. I'll not see you tomorrow, Adrian. I'm off to Manchester.
Oh, well, before you go, Sefton, I'd like these two lads to know what you've done for us. Your Uncle Sefton has let us have this house.
Now, Edwin, you're embarrassing me.
Stop.
Excuse me. Robert.
Never thought you were coming.
Hello, Maggie.
David.
It's quite an occasion, isn't it?
Oh, it's lovely to see you. Where have you been?
Well, he's been to West Africa buying tables off bamboats with pairs of socks I knitted for him.
Yeah, I've got a present for you upstairs.
What a lovely surprise.
Well, I'll leave you to it.
We should have warned you. It's too late now, but, well, just be careful what you say, that's all.
She's just popped upstairs. She thought she heard John George sneeze.
Michael, this is David. This is Robert. Michael Armstrong, Margaret's friend.
Put the kettle on for your bottle, honey. Why did Michael have to come? Just when the boys are here.
Well, it'll be nice and warm.
Don't worry.
Well, they have a right to know what's going on, Dad.
But I'd rather she told you herself.
But she can't, can she? Not with this lot around. Oh, come on, Dad. I've got to get away in a minute. Look, she's pregnant. Is it him, the chap she's with?
Yes. Yes, it is.
It's just not like her, Maggie, that. He wants punching.
Oh, David.
Well,
there's more to it than I can explain, certainly in a few minutes. All I can say is that, much as it hurts me, I think I can understand.
Understand? He wants his bloody neck.
Now, look here, David, I don't want any more trouble. I've enough with your mother as it is. Now, that's definite. If I can try to bring myself to understand, I shouldn't have thought it was beyond you to do the same.
Oh, the pot calling the kettle black.
I didn't say
that. Well, I'll say it for you then. Look, Dad, what I've done with my life, well, that's how it's been. Doesn't mean to say I like myself for it, but I'll make it. Is he going to marry her?
Well, that's another problem.
Because of John, you mean?
That's about it. Are you going to join the others in the shelter?
No, I want to see Sheila, you know. I've only got the one night at home.
Well, don't hang about in the streets too long. It's not too good, the receiving end. Especially the last few nights.
Not so good at the other end, either, Dad.
No. No, that's all you know. You say goodbye to your mother?
Yeah.
Dad?
Yeah?
Have I got to go in the shelter tonight?
Yes. If it's only to keep your mother happy.
Well, I'm away in a minute, Rob. Have a good leave, kid.
Same to you, Dave.
Hey, we'll have to have a night out one of these days.
Yeah, great.
Ta-ra.
Ta-ra.
Oh, it just puts you off, doesn't it, Dad?
Off what?
Oh, I don't know. Maggie and... just puts you off, that's all.
You look after yourself. We'll sort out the troubles at home.
It's all right, Dad. Be lucky.
Goodbye, David. Take care, son.
Good night.
Good night. Hello. I thought you were with the others. Where's Michael?
He's gone to the shelter with Mum and Margaret.
Well, hadn't you better hurry up and join them?
I'm just going. Is David gone?
Just.
How do you take it?
It was a shock, of course.
Well, there's another one waiting for him when he gets home.
Huh?
Sheila's got a lodger.
A lodger? Who?
Doris from work. Why? What do you think I was going to say? That she'd got wise to him, that she was playing out his own game?
Now, Frieda.
Serve him right if she did.
And the kids, would it serve them right?
I'll tell you one thing, Dad. You'll not get me off your hands in a hurry. I'm right off matrimony at the moment.
Trousers on.
Yeah, I can see that. You wouldn't like to tell me how you came to take them off, I suppose.
Where have you been? What have you been doing?
What have I been doing? What have you been doing, more like?
You're going to be all right.
Oh, don't worry. I'll dive for the nearest shelter if I hear anything coming.
I'm sorry about that. All the family being there, I mean.
That's all right.
I find it a bit grim, too, sometimes, you know.
Yes, I know you do.
It'll get better. It's just living through it, isn't it? It's up to me, I suppose, to talk to Mum about it. I mean, now that Robert's back.
I wouldn't push her too hard.
We've got to make a decision sometime. I mean, sooner or later, we...
Better to let things take their course.
You don't mind anymore, do you?
I mind for you. Of course I do.
Michael.
You're still buzzing about it.
Take care, won't you?
Also.
Good night, then. Kettle'll be boiling in a minute. I'll put a load of sugar in his tea, sweeten him up a bit. Was it awful
for him? Oh, no. It's for him, I should think.
Don't let him catch us laughing when he comes in. He's so embarrassed. Serves him right for not letting me know he was coming back. He's going to come back here one day and find I've moved.
Hey, he's dead strong on you, though, isn't he?
Is he? What makes you say that?
Oh, I don't know. I can just tell, that's all.
Oh, shut up. Are you ready for a cup of tea, then, love?
Yeah, why not?
Is it quiet outside?
Well, there's a bit of a fire going on over towards the river. But you'll be all right.
Oh, yeah, right. Well, I'll go up then. Can I borrow your torch?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Friend of your Frieda's.
Yeah, you said.
Yes, they went to a dance at the Naffy. She's been bombed out.
Well, is she going to be here every time I come home?
Well, she's company for me, that's all. She can have the kids' room if she decides to stay, you know, when things are normal. If they ever do get normal, won't be much left if things go on like this, will there? Just one bad raid after another, ever since April.
Shh. Listen. Are you glad to see me?
Yes. Well, you look tired, David.
Yes, well, I've been dying for my own bed.
Oh, dear. Oh, I'm sorry you said that.
Why?
Because you're going to be disappointed.
Why am I going to be disappointed?
David, your face.
Why am I going to be disappointed?
Because I've chucked it out and I've bought us another one.
Oh, you have me what a death.
You were just going to go nasty on me then, weren't you? You don't mind?
No. Oh. Good riddance to bad rubbish, I'd
say.
Oh,
you said you're dying for it, didn't you?
You're a great little kid, aren't you, eh?
I thought to myself, now, what can I do to take my mind off it, you know, the bombing and all that? And I thought, I know, I'm going to buy us a new bed. So I did. I just went straight out and I bought it.
Just like that?
Yeah, just like that.
Well, look, you go and tuck Flossie up and I'll test the springs, right?
Oh, David, we can't do that. What, in the middle of an air raid? Well, you don't know what it's like. I'm terrified if I'm upstairs.
It's dead quiet out.
Yes, I know, but...
Look, I tell you what, the minute anything starts, down we come, right?
What, guns or anything?
Yeah, anything.
You're an old devil. You are, aren't you?
What, me? No. I'm just a fella on a 48-hour pass. Do you remember what you used to say?
What?
It was like a second honeymoon.
Mm-hmm. You know all the right things to say, don't you?
Yes, all right, Bert. I've got that. Ta. Come in. Michael,
thought I'd drop in on my way. Cozy little place, isn't it?
Yes, you get quite attached to it after a bit. Being up at night, too. Like living in another world. You miss the sleep, of course, but it has its compensations.
You believe in this war, don't you, Mr. Ashton?
Don't quite get you, son.
You believe that we've got to fight it. But what'll happen if we don't will be worse than, well, fighting and so on.
I think so, yes.
You're not absolutely sure?
Yes, I'm sure on that point.
I see.
You get a lot of people saying it's good versus evil. I suppose that's true to a certain extent. But I'm not so sure about the good. Evil versus something that's less than good, but it happens to be what the enemy stands for. That's a bit nearer the mark for me, I think. And, of course, there are always those times when you don't feel sure about anything. When our Philip went to Spain, and then Robert going off to sea at 16 years of age. Things like that. And there was John, of course. Do we talk about John?
Yes. Yes, of course.
He was a bit like me in some ways, not too sure where he stood most of the time, except that it was something that had to be got through. But then, most of these things are decided for us these days, aren't they?
They are, yes. For most people.
I couldn't even tell you what his politics were. But then, there always seems to have been some sort of conspiracy of silence about politics between people like us.
Yes.
I know you have views, of course.
Wish I did.
You're a registered conscientious objector, aren't you?
That's the problem. I think I'm beginning to believe as you do. It's a bit shattering after years of believing the other thing. That's why... Well, I'm not sure Margaret and I should live together. If I find I do believe in this war, then I'll have to join in and help to fight it. It's the only decent thing I could do, isn't it?
And risk her having to go through it all again? Like she did with John?
What's the alternative, Mr. Ashton?
How's that?
Oh, much better. How does it feel, then?
Oh, it's always great.
The bed drafts.
Oh, yeah. Smash it. Bang on.
She's good, isn't it? You can lie right on the edge without rolling into the door.
How much did you pay for it?
£7.05.
What, you been saving up?
Oh, yeah. I've been saving it for ages, not just for this.
You're a right little capitalist, aren't you?
Yes. You don't think it was extravagant, do you?
Well, it all depends, doesn't it? I'll, have to give it my expert.
Baby, come on!
Sheila, it's all right, come here! Come here, Sheila! They're after the docks, I tell you! You rotten, lousy bastards!
To rush.
Oh, what time did the all clear go?
Soon after four. You dropped off when we came in and I hadn't the heart to wake you.
I should get cracking, hadn't I?
You just lie there and drink your tea. I called you 10 minutes early on purpose.
Is Robert up yet?
Robert can stay in bed all day if he wants to. Breakfast in bed today, I think.
That's right. You spoil him and enjoy yourself. I won't be back till after tea today, Mum.
Won't you, dear? Something on at the school?
No, I'm going round to Michael's.
Oh, I see. Will you be staying for tea?
Yes, I think I will. Mum.
Yes, dear?
I know what I've done has upset you terribly, and I'm sorry. That's why I haven't said anything before about what we plan to do.
You and Michael.
You see, Michael asked me some time ago to go and live with him, and I'm going to tell him tonight that I will. It seems the only practical thing to do.
Yes, I suppose it does.
You won't be too unhappy about it.
I won't be able to be completely happy about it. I'm made the way I am, and... we all have things that make us more unhappy than others. I try to be intelligent about it, of course. But when you're brought up in a certain way, you can't entirely ignore your emotions.
I'm sorry.
No. No. So long as you're happy.
Awake?
Yes.
Where's Admiral Jellicoe? Snoring his head off, I suppose.
It's the boy's first day home. You're expecting to be up with a lark. You've forgotten what time we went to bed. Why can't you have a meal in a restaurant now and again?
What's wrong?
I've just been talking to Margaret.
I see.
Michael's asked her to live with him.
Has he?
Under the circumstances, I suppose it's the only practical thing to do.
Yes, perhaps it is.
She's going to see him tonight. Oh,
he's fast asleep. I don't like to wake him. Well, what do you think he'll be blood in the restaurant? Not him.
Hey, what can you do about work?
Oh, I won't do it today. No, he'd go mad if he makes something for me to come to work. Can you phone the Nuffy for me when you get to your place?
Yeah, of course. Thanks. Are you sure you want me to come back tonight?
be daft. Anyway, he's going back tonight.
Oh, well, I'm working late anyway.
Stop being daft. You're embarrassing.
All right. Do you want me to bring anything back?
No, because I've got to go out shopping with something like it.
Since you came home.
He's saving them up.
Looks like it. I hope these weren't the ones you gave that gentleman in the...
Gunboat.
Yes, that's it. Because if they were, goodness knows what sort of home he thought you'd come from. Well, that'll be the milkman, love. Tell him I'll pay tomorrow, will you?
Okay. Oh, hello.
Hello, Robert. David told me you were home. You've been to Africa, haven't you?
Yeah, Mum's in the kitchen.
Ooh, did you enjoy it?
Fine, thanks.
Oh, dear. It's your beautiful white shirt with oil all over it. Thought you was dirty washing, has he?
Hello, love.
Is David with you?
No, I've left him in bed. I bought you that half pound of butter that I owe you.
Oh, you shouldn't have bothered.
Oh, come on, I can manage. Anyway, it's rations. Well, you're looking better already.
Better?
Must be having Robert home, is it?
Does it show?
Yeah, it shows.
Sheila! Sheila!
Marvellous, love. Hey, you seen her holding all these socks?
I thought sailors were supposed to be well up on, darling.
This one certainly isn't.
Mum, I hate to spring it on you like this, but do you think I should have my bath now instead of on Thursday?
Yes, of course you can, love. I've got the water hot for Robert, but he can have his later. Can't you, love?
Can't I what?
Have your bath later.
Later the better.
See? Good. I'll go up. I've got my own towel.
I'll make you some tea when you come down.
How about it, then?
About what?
Any odd jobs you want doing?
Odd jobs, indeed. You just relax and enjoy yourself. Guess you'd like to darn this lot, eh?
Sheila, what time is it?
Oh, it's 4:00. Oh, what time does your train go?
6:00 from Lime Street.
Hey, do you know you make noises?
Noises?
When you sleep.
What sort of noises?
Oh, I don't know, just noises. When do you finish your tour?
I've finished it a few up since.
But you mean you'll be offline for a bit then, will you?
Yeah. I don't know, you know, maybe.
Maybe?
Yeah, maybe I will, maybe I won't. I'm not far off my commission, you know. Pilot Officer Ashton. How do you fancy that, then?
You saw the kids, didn't you, David?
Yeah, who told you?
Mrs. Thomas wrote and told me. Excited, were they?
Jamie was, yeah. I hardly saw Peter. He'd gone off exploring or something. I hardly had two words with him.
Mrs. Thomas says he's stopped wetting the bed now. very happy there, aren't they?
When did you last go?
Well, the first week in April. Oh, it upsets me, though, Davy, when I have to come away, you know.
Yeah. Can you lend me 5 quid?
5 quid?
Yeah, well, I'm skint till I get paid. I don't get paid, you know, until the day after tomorrow.
Well, yes, I know, love, but 5 quid. Can't make do with less.
Look, I need 5 quid.
Do you owe it or something?
Look, if you can't lend it to me, just say so.
You do owe it, don't you?
Yeah, all right, I
owe it. David, I'm saving that money for us, for after it's over, to give us some kind of a start.
Just forget it.
Got what you came for then, have you?
Are you trying to make me feel rotten again?
Or was it the £5 you
wanted? Oh, thanks.
Well, what do you expect me to think? I'm saving that money for us, David, for our future.
Future? What future? Do you know what my future is, Sheila? Do you know where it ends, my future? The minute I step into that bloody plane, that's where my future ends.
Yes, I know, David.
You know. How do you know, Sheila? You know nothing. Nothing.
You can have the money.
Why didn't you say so in the first place?
Because I worry about you, David. I worry, you know, in case you try to be something that you're not. When I came down to see you at the base that time, I don't know. It wasn't like seeing you here. I worry in case you go away from me for good.
Sheila.
Oh, David, don't leave me. Please. Don't change.
What a sweet letter. Her spelling seems to be better, too.
She asks about you.
Oh, where?
Over the page.
Are you still friends with Mrs. Porter? Well, are you still friends with Mrs. Porter?
I've reassured her on that point.
You'd like to reassure me, too, would you?
I'm still friends with Mrs. Porter.
I mean it, Michael. Things aren't as they were, are they?
Oh, come on now.
I suppose pregnant women are a bit oversensitive about these things.
About what things?
Well, there you were, impatient for me to come and live with you, and then, bang, you seem to go cold on the whole thing.
In a way.
I see.
Not in the way you're thinking. I spoke to your father about it.
Oh, when?
Last night.
You might have spoken to me first.
I didn't plan it that way. It just happened, that's all. I told him I didn't know how long I could stay as CEO. And if I decide I can't...
You'll join up. Is that it?
Would I have any other option?
You're not sure yet.
I just wonder, when it's all over, and assuming we win, whatever that means, whether it won't all be just like the last lot, an accident of history, the great cause just a sham, the powers of darkness no darker than the so-called powers of light, or very little anyway.
I can't think about it like that. I just feel threatened.
One doesn't mind being a tool of history. It's how the tools are used that matters.
Well, what about us?
Well, it just means that if I did join up, it wouldn't be possible for us to live together for a while.
Might as well go home then.
Don't be silly. You can't in this. And I don't want you to anyway.
You believe it, don't you? You think that's all it would mean, that we just simply couldn't live together. But don't you see that if you did join up, you'd be asking me to go through it all again, everything that I went through with John, and I can't face it, Michael. I can't.
Get down! Get down!
Thank you.